这是一个手机 APP 全面渗透进我们生活的时代。早上起来看天气，我们点开 Weather， 出门坐车点开 Uber， 约会吃饭求助大众点评，买东西少不了某宝某东，大量的休闲时光更是泡在了微信和朋友圈里。于是脑洞大开的创业者们发现了更紧密绑定我们的契机。
We looked at the mobile app landscape and we asked ourselves, where are there big opportunities?
So Button is building the future of mobile commerce. We're a platform.
看深度链接，让手机 app 们做朋友，开辟移动时代创业新路子。
我叫静，在纽约生活，和大部分80后90后一样，手机里装满了各种各样的 APP。 生活中不管是出行、购物、社交，甚至约会都离不开它们，只是不同 APP 之间的来回来去的切换成为了便利之中唯一的不便。但最近我发现 APP 之间可以这样玩，晚上约吃饭，点链接就能看 Yelp 口碑评论，中意这家餐厅，直接查看地图。想叫车，不用复制粘贴 ，Uber 就知道我要去哪里。点个按钮就能跳到 Foursquare 订桌位。
深度链接，让移动生活更美好。Deep linking， 深度链接。这个大众还陌生的名词已经在移动软件开发者和产品经理们中间开始走红，它到底是什么？让一家带我们去了解 Deep Linking 的正确打开方式。
Hi Michael.
Thank you so much for coming. Welcome.
Yeah, today let's talk about one concept first. What is Deep Linking?
Deep Linking is what enables that journey for the customer to come into that specific place within that application, and before that existed, it was a really tough and almost impossible challenge for developers to solve.
Button 的联合创始人兼首席执行官，曾是乐天集团最年轻的行政总监，先后成功创建过两家公司。
Deep linking is a way to make information and content that's within an app accessible. Similar to the way that information is accessible on the web.
Button 的联合创始人兼首席营收官，曾负责 PayPal、谷歌钱包等网络支付平台的建立。2014年，和 Michael Jackley 在内的六名创始人共同创建了提供移动网络深度链接的平台 Button。
Tell us what is Button.
So Button is building the future of mobile commerce. We're a platform that helps connect mobile applications, and it's really creating a new framework for app developers to come and be able to form partnerships with companies where they think they can enhance the experiences of the apps that they're building.
Cool. Can you show me how Button looks like on an app?
Yeah. So, what's your favorite restaurant? Okay,
let's do mine.
Bianca.
Okay.
So, if we want to take an Uber to Bianca, you'll see Button right here. And so, we render this Uber button. And so, if you tap this button,What we then show is this customized experience, which is all of Button's content, and we're rendering here the estimated time and the estimated fare. And so if you tap that Uber Black button, it's deep linked with the address into Uber, so all you have to do is touch a button to book, and that address will be pre-filled when you get into the car.
Cool, very nice.How many apps in your cell phone?
I think I got around 100 maybe.
Yeah, I think I got like 20 to 25.
I believe I have like 20 or more apps.
Or 15 or 20 apps.
I only have the ones that are the most important, so I would say not too much.
Like a good solid 4 or 5 I use.
Which one you use more often?
That might be like some of the social media, like Facebook or Instagram, and especially Snapchat.
I use Facebook the most.
Facebook.
Facebook. Snapchat, Instagram, and Pandora.
Skype, YouTube.
Do you think like you can live without the cell phone app?
No, not really.
It's the first thing I do in the morning, and the last thing I do before I go to sleep.
Living without a cell phone is like living in the Stone Ages.
I guess that would be tough.
I could definitely live without them.
We can live on the street, it's better. It's real.
My feeling is Budding is trying to catch up the revolution of on-demand needs. Is that the reason you quit your job in Rakuten and started this company?
Yes, I think so. I mean, for me, it was looking at the trend that was emerging inside of this on-demand economy and the explosive nature of growth that all of these companies were representing. And if you study mobile and think about the general size of the opportunity, frankly, there shouldn't be anything that has come before mobile and mobile commerce. By the year 2020, people predict that 80% of the population will have smartphones.
The problem that we saw in the opportunity at Button was, you know, if you think of commerce at the bottom of funnel, we saw great payment solutions from Android Pay to Apple Pay to PayPal to Stripe to Braintree, and those problems and Visa Checkout and others solving the payments problem. At the top of funnel, we saw folks like Google, Facebook solving sort of the ads problem. But there was this area in the middle, and we were talking a lot about it today, about sort of deep linking and connecting apps to one another, that individual apps are sort of silos and it's hard to move between them.
毫无疑问，我们已经进入了无处不移动的时代，自然吃喝玩乐加消费也转向了移动平台。去年中国全民狂欢的双十一就创下了令人瞠目的571亿元的销售记录。据统计，一半的电子购物是通过手机或者平板完成的。这样一来，是不是能够尽可能顺畅地满足客户需求的消费体验，成为了移动商业浪潮中一个简单粗暴的标杆
？Button found its own kind of niche market. Do you think so?
We'd like to think so. I think the way that money is made in mobile payments and mobile commerce is going to get increasingly complex. And then on the commerce front, I think there's a lot of innovation that will happen about how apps will be connected to one another and how transactions will be facilitated across apps. The overall amount of payments that are happening on mobile devices is going to grow by just an astonishing and unbelievable amount. So the overall pie of money flows is growing, which makes more opportunity for startups as well as big companies.
For me, the most exciting thing was to say, can we solve what consumers want on a daily basis and show them a button to fulfill that need? And I felt like the opportunity couldn't be better with the growth of this market and where we were positioned.
And I guess you already talked to so many VC people and angels. What's their attitude towards the concept, like deep linking? And
Button's concept is different, and I think different than most of the other companies that are in this category. But I think that the deep linking thesis and what commercial opportunity that deep linking will provide is something akin to what, you know, Google exposed in the first dot-com era and, you know, has become one of the largest companies in the world through.
Uber 作为移动 APP 中的领军者，率先开始了和 Button 的合作。
I think that the most memorable moment was when Uber elected to present Button at the keynote that they gave at the developer conference. That was something that for all of our team was, you know, a very exciting moment for, you know, an executive at Uber to be talking about a six-month-old company.
That was the most exciting day, and it was sort of in the summer of last year, and it was really exciting.
So, but as a small company, like at the very beginning, as a startup, it must be hard to talk to a big company like Uber.
Yeah.
So what's your approach?
We're in a world where you need both a phenomenal technology product, that's one thing, but two, you do need credibility. It's not cold calling. We do very, very little outbound where we're talking to a company that isn't aware of us or doesn't know me or somebody else at the company. What we tend to do is either get a warm introduction through our network, again, built through years of, you know, being expert practitioners in our various areas within this broad commerce space, or we were very, very deliberate about how we chose our investor partners as well. So folks with domain expertise, folks with geographic expertise, and folks with great networks.
I think it's an awesome question, and it's one that we have to answer every day. And the real reason is because we bring scale and speed and simplicity. So if you are a company like Foursquare and, you know, contemplating an Uber integration and maybe five other companies that you want to put in, by working with Button, you can do the work of integrating one and get access to many. And so that marketplace dynamic is the same theme that many businesses have been built upon successfully, which is come to us and we'll give you access to many, and it will be much simpler, and this is our specialty.
感谢百度百家对本栏目的支持，登录百度百家一家频道，获取创业美国更多资讯。
试着说一说。
做软件之间的桥梁，当任何一方通过他们的搭桥获得收益， Button 就能从中分成。 Uber 愿意这样的尝试，但其他商家有多少肯从收入中和 Button 分一杯羹呢？
Ever receive any rejection?
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
That's basically, you know, the key to succeeding as a revenue and partnerships leader at a growing company is not taking a no personally. You're going to get, you know, 5 out of 6 no's. It could be more at different times. No is the name of the game. So you have to understand that, but you also have to learn from those no's.
What's the most difficult part to persuade them?
We're not building for where the world is today. So in a lot of cases, what we have to do when talking to prospective partners is paint them a vision of the future and say, that's where we want to go. Let us take you there. And so that's our biggest challenge, is having people understand where we think the world's going.
全球最大的电商市场，不好意思，不是美国，而是中国。专家预计2015年销售额将冲到5亿6200万美金，而美国仅以3亿4900万位居第二。 Button 的创业者们深知这一点，他们甚至表示自己的技术是拿美国市场做试水，照着为中国市场量身定做的。
Button's partner Uber now is in China. So what's your impression about Chinese market?
Well, I mean, for the emergence, you know, of this, you know, dominant middle class that is becoming digitally savvy and adopting for the first time, their first splash into digital is through smartphones. You know, we've specifically been thoughtful from the very beginning about how we are going to connect to China, and some of it is through the investors that we've had, you know, join us from DCM, which is, you know, a big presence in China. In addition to Redpoint, we feel like that market is going to be a very strategic one for us. And for that, you know, Button is building technology that we're seeing adopted in China for the U.S. market, but we hope will also be used there.
Wow.
The Button rooftop.
Lovely.
We host barbecues up here all the time. We'll have a big party up here tomorrow night.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
So everyone will be here.
We host meetups. up here. And then last night we had Airbnb was up here on the roof doing an event.
Sort of early on, as we were co-founders coming together with a business idea, we met regularly at this restaurant, Feast, and we were working together, putting together our business plan. Then the six of us, once we we closed on our seed financing, we did the lease for this space, and we shared it with our first two partners, which were Drizzly and 1-1, and this space looked entirely different.
The collection of moments that fits alongside that is every acceptance letter we've got from our hires, from our team.
What was your reaction?
Time. I mean, when we get a hire here, we invest so heavily and we scrutinize so hard on who we bring in that when someone does get to that, you know, final stage and accepts, it's a really big moment for us.
说起 Button 的诞生和成长，大家对刚开始创建 Button 时的情景仍然记忆犹新。六个联合创始人，这在创业公司中是比较少见的。来自不同背景、性格各异的六个兄弟，从借用餐厅的小角落，到今日靠着各自的工作经验、人际网络，把这样一个特别的移动经济创业理念推广实现。Michael 他们并没有过多的感慨，创业就是这么一回事。在这条道路上，他们还会走得更远。